Okay, guys, as you're coming in, the lucky ones, but the unlucky ones, since it's only 25 allowed, the unlucky ones will have to watch the YouTube video. I am recording the webinar, so it will be live, it will be on YouTube probably tomorrow, whenever I have time. Guys, I have to remember, I am a full-time trader after all, and I'm not getting paid for any of this work that I do, I'm doing all of this to help people, so don't expect too much of me. Okay, let's just give it a moment for everyone to get to the room, or for the first 25 to at least get into the room. Dion, is that Dion Bertha Richards? Okay, so we're just busy filling up. There's about 10 people in now. Okay, let's see how many people we've got in, if it's full yet. I know we still got some space. Still got some space for a few people to log on. But now can you just post again the new ID, please? Still got space for 5 more people. Okay, guys, sorry, if you could type again your name and where you are from, that would be nice. Where in the country or where internationally you are from. You guys do know we have mentoring sessions in Joburg in person, in Cape Town, and mostly in Umhlanga. Umhlanga, we actually do 2 sessions per week, a Monday from 4 till 6 and a Wednesday from 3 till 4. And then we'll be doing 2 online mentoring sessions. And we'll be doing 2 online mentoring sessions per week as well. One for beginners, done by my partner Sandile Shezi, and the other one done by me for the more advanced students. Okay, some Joburg boys, good. We're doing a course in Joburg this weekend, actually. Some dealers going up there. Japan, Marcelo, welcome. Wow, we got some people following from all over the world. This is awesome. I'm definitely going to sort out the software so that we can get more of you on the next webinar. 25 people is ridiculous. If I knew that TeamViewer had that limitation, I never would have used it. Port Cape Town, we come down to Cape Town in a month or so. I hope you booked your ticket. It's going to be completely free. Okay, so I think that's enough in the room, and we will start now. So let's get my video up. Yeah. Hi, everyone. My name is George from Global Forex Institute. Well, technically, I'm a mentor for Global Forex Institute, and I'm the head trader. Welcome to this webinar, and I hope to see you guys for the next ones as well. Let's change back to my screen view so we can start talking about what's actually going on here. Okay, so on my screen here, we can see on my screen, give me 1 second. Are you one of the 25? So my co-presenter wasn't quick enough to be one of the first 25, so he's not in the room. Okay, guys, can you see my screen? Can you guys see my screen? I hope so. Well, if you can, yeah, guys, here's my live account. So as you can see, I'm not like all these other guys who can't trade and pretend they can so they teach other people and make their money like that. I don't charge money for anything. I do all my classes for free. All the mentoring that I do is for free. You can see the size of my account here, and you can see that it's a real account. Okay, so there's no need for me to charge you guys money for classes, for signals, for anything. If you go to SA Traders Lounge, you'll see I post a lot of my trades on there. We'll look at some of them today, so I'll show you the analysis that went into it. I'm going to keep it as simple as possible, so I chose the trades that don't have any advanced techniques. Let's start. Okay, before we start, the Global Forex Institute website, it's got some educational material that you guys should go check out. There's training manuals, a basic one and an advanced one. Very, very good stuff. There's a book called The Art of War. It's obviously, everything is for free. The Art of War, it's one of the best books you could ever read. It's 2,000 years old. It's about war strategy, and we use it in strategy during trading. It's amazing. You can open a broker's account by clicking Start Trading here. We've got an awesome deal with INFX. You only need $50 to open an account. You get spreads from zero, and they give you bonuses of up to 30,000 Rand. It's you don't get any better than that. Under the investment tab, you can see my PAM account that people can invest in. You guys are all welcome to invest. Below the graph, this is a live graph of how the account is doing. Below it, you can see exactly how to open your account and link it to mine. I'm very happy to help you with a phone call as well. Once you have opened and funded your account, I'll chat to you on the phone. What else is important on here? The booking page. If you want to book a free seat anywhere in the country, just click your city, fill in the details, and check your email, okay? I've got a question here. I don't have a local PAM account. No, this PAM account is hosted in Singapore. It's with the biggest broker in Asia, and the reason I use them is because they've got a wonderful PAM interface, and the way everything works automatically is great. There's no monthly charges or startup fees or anything. Once again, I don't need money. I've made plenty of money trading. I can tell you right now, anyone trying to sell you Forex courses for 10,000 or 100,000, I've seen a company doing it in Joburg for 108,000. They are not making money from trading. Also, wouldn't have to charge you that kind of money for the courses. Okay? Don't be silly. If a guy is selling you a robot for $100, that robot is not working. You would be using it himself if it was working. Like, think about it, guys. Right, that's about it. Let's get to the charts. And the first one is the US dollar South African rand. It was called in SA Traders Lounge, this trade, and the date we'll see is the 11th of the 5th, 2014. So it's quite a while ago we entered it. Any of you guys got any idea why we entered? Let's start to know why I entered at this spot right here. Let me draw a little blue. Let me draw a little rectangle where we actually entered. That is where we entered the trade. Can anyone tell me why they think we entered there? Divergence, I see. I've decided to leave divergence out of this because most people were requesting a beginner's course. So I'm only using Fibonacci, trend lines, and stochastics, overbought, oversold. By the way, guys, I don't use any indicators. There are no smart magical indicators. They don't exist. I promise you. You can spend as much money as you want. If you want, go to a website called forexwinners.net. You can download any paid indicators there for free. Robots, all that sort of stuff. None of it is going to be worth any of your time. Okay, if someone has something that works, you'll either give it away for free or he'll keep it for himself. He's not going to sell it. Okay? Right. Oversold stochastics, absolutely right. If we get the crosshair out, we can see here stochastics is below the zero line. So stochastics was oversold. That's one of my reasons for taking the trade. Yes. Another reason, let's pop some trend lines up. Yeah, look at that. How stunning that trend line looks. Perfect, perfect, perfect. Well, I'm drawing my trend lines like a beginner, yeah? I feel so bad for all these people who have to turn away from the meeting. A little trick with trend lines, if you want to draw channels, hold down your control key while your first trend line is selected as such and drag it up and you'll get a parallel trend so you can see exactly how the channel is running. And the markets love to run in channels like this. It happens all the time. Perfect parallel channels. So we've got one reason. The stochastics is oversold. Can anyone give me another reason? Thanks, Emmanuel, for your reason, but seems like the other guys are all quiet. It's a pullback from an uptrend. Yes, it's a perfect uptrend. That's another good reason to buy here. It's a perfect uptrend. Fundamentally, the South African government has been messing up. Okay, so the rand has been getting weaker and weaker. So from a fundamental point, I don't think the ANC is suddenly going to start changing policies that's going to improve the rand, right? I don't think fundamentally anything is going to change up to this trend. I think it's going to keep going up. The rand's going to keep worsening. So fundamentally, that's another reason why I would buy. Your stochastics is oversold. As we said, we've got a candle here. You guys see this candle? Let me zoom in. See this doji right here? On the weekly chart, a doji. That's where I bought. It's right by the trend line, so we're expecting a bounce on the trend line. Okay, let me just zoom out here again. We're expecting a bounce on the trend line, clearly. We've got the bounce. See how nicely the market is respecting that trend line, that support line. We've got our stochastics, which at that point is just turning back from an oversold position. And when we draw our Fibonacci from the previous low up to the high, we can see that we were in the area between the 50 and the 61.8. I like to refer to that area as the Fib zone. Okay, none of the other lines on the Fibonacci mean squat to me. It's all smoke and mirrors, guys. Forget those lines. Keep it simple. Fibonacci is only there to find the Fib zone. When the price is in the area between the 50 and the 61.8, that's the most likely area for the pullback to stop. So we've got a point A over here. The market pushed up to point B over there, touched the top of the channel line, and we came back down to point C. Fibonacci shows us that point C will be somewhere in this area. It shows us that point C will be somewhere in this area, the area between the 50 and the 61.8. And in this area, we also get that C info, candle info, a doji. Okay, very easy trade, very simple. I mean, most beginners also know about this, right? I see, what do we see here? David says resistance break and resistance retest. Absolutely, yeah, we've got some previous resistance over here. So previous resistance becoming support. Absolutely spot on, David, very well spotted. Very well spotted. That's another basic that all of you should know. If you go to any of our free beginners classes, you will know about S and R swaps, support resistance flips. Okay, so let's count the reasons why we went long here. We were in the flip zone. That's one reason. We're bouncing on a trend line, a support line. That's a second reason. We've got stochastics oversold. That's a third reason. We've got a previous support, previous resistance, sorry, becoming support. That's a fourth reason. We've got an uptrend. That's a fifth reason. We've got fundamentals also telling us we're going up. That's a sixth reason. And then if we did look at MACD divergence, which I'm not going to do because most of you asked for a beginner's seminar or a beginner's mentoring session, but there's MACD divergence as well on the smaller time frames. We look at the monthly chart. I always like to look one chart up. You can see this is a crazy uptrend. And look at this lovely candle. Let me just delete that. Look at this lovely hammer that we've got here. Yeah, perfect place to say that this little pullback is finished and we're now moving up for the new highs and taking them out, I would imagine. My stop loss, as you can see, is not tight. That's one of the biggest mistakes newbies make, is they put their stop losses tight. Don't put your stop loss tight. Give the market some space to move. Sometimes the big boys will even break this support line deliberately. And they'll force the market through just to hunt your stops. And then the market will go up. Okay, so keep your stop fairly away. I mean, this one is even quite tight. It's 200 pips. Below the low over here. Okay, remember we're on a weekly chart. It's on a daily chart. As you can see, there's 200 pips. Okay. Right, enough about that trade. Any questions, guys? Does it top? No, guys. About candles, I'm going to make it very simple for you. You get all these names about engulfing candles and this and that. And to be fair, you can forget all about it. All about it. That count. Okay, a doji and then two other candles. If the market's moving down and you get a hammer, in other words, a candle with a longer wick at the bottom than what the body is big. Okay, an example of a hammer would be, this is technically a hammer. The wick is a little bit longer than the body. Let's see, where's another better example of a hammer. Here's a beautiful hammer, very small body, huge handle. Okay, a hammer, when the market has been moving down, a hammer shows you that we're turning up. A doji would do the same. If the market is moving up, an upside down hammer, that's not the correct term, but you could call it that if you want to. I don't care what you call it. It's a shooting star, a morning star, whatever you like to call it. You can't even call it an upside down hammer if you like. That shows you that the market wants to now move down. Okay, so as you can see here, the market moved up. We got our shooting star or upside down hammer or whatever you want to call it. And we moved down. We came down and we got a doji or a hammer and we moved up. So you're looking for, when we're moving up, you're looking for a candle with a wick that sticks up to tell you we're going to turn down. When we're moving down, you're looking for a candle with a wick that sticks down to tell you we're moving up. That's all you need to know about candles, guys. All this, all, if you look on the internet, you're going to find over 100 different candle patterns. And I tell you what, none of them are high probability. I just showed you a trade now with how many was that? 6 or 7 different reasons for entering? That's a high probability trade. That's all I'm interested in. Okay, I'm only interested in high probability trades. And that is why you can see that I very rarely go under 80% success rate with my trades. As you can see here, it's above 80. It briefly went below 80 over here. The rest of the time, it's all between 80 and 90% win ratio. That means I win 8 or 9 out of every 10 trades. Okay, because I don't just take any trade. I don't want just one reason to get into a trade. I don't want 2 reasons. I want a few reasons. Okay, the more reasons, the better. Let me look at some questions here. See if I can answer, because I feel like I'm going crazy and I'm talking to myself. analysis for 4 hours in daily time frame. Guys, okay, I'll zoom in more. Someone asked, is that maybe a little bit too much? How's that? Is that a bit better, guys? 4 hourlies, yes. I trade from the 4 hourlies up to the monthlies. The bigger the time frame, the better the trade, because the more pips you're going to get out of it and the longer it's going to run. Guys, trading under 1 hour time frames are making the brokers very happy, because you're paying a big percentage of your money towards the spread. So your trade becomes more expensive. Plus, that is erratic market movement. It can't be predicted properly. Okay, all these scalping systems, all these short-term 5-minute systems that people are trying to sell you, forget it. I've never met a trader, a successful trader, that can show me his results that uses anything under 1 hour or even 4 hours. Okay, I won't look at anything under 4 hours. I might time a trade on a 1 hour time frame, but my analysis is always done in bigger time frames. This one was done in the weekly. Okay, do you draw your fibs from top to bottom or bottom to top? Very, very good question. And all the beginners have this problem. All the beginners have this problem. And why did I choose this starting point for my fib? Simply because this is a point that stands out, right? And that is a point that stands out. Now, if I'm buying, I'm looking to buy, the market made an impulse wave, a big push up, as you guys can see, right? From here up to here. That's an impulse wave. Now, you draw your fib the same way as the impulse wave. If you're looking to buy, the market made a push up, so you draw your fibs from bottom to top. You draw your fibs up, just like the impulse wave. And then you sit back and wait for the retracement. Tick, tock, tick, tock, tick, tock. Your trap for price is here in the fib zone, between the 50 and the 61.8. That's what I'm waiting for. This took many, many weeks. As you can see, it took 15 weeks from the top until we got to the fib zone. But I patiently waited. There's a lot of currency pairs that I can trade. But 15 weeks later, we got in the zone and I started looking for candle info. We were at the trend line. The stochastics were looking good. I got the candle info and bam, I bought it. If the market was moving down, if it was a downtrend, and I'll show you a downtrend, then we're going to move, draw our fibs from top to bottom. Okay, if there's no more questions about this one, I'm going to move straight over to one where we draw our fibs the other way around, just to give you guys an idea, because I know fibs is always a problem for beginners. Okay, how do you base your stop loss and take profit? My stop loss, as I already said, is 200 pips below the 61.8 and below this trend line. Okay, it's not 10 pips below there, because the market might spike through when they stop, when they do stop loss hunting. It's 200 pips below. Okay, but that's fine, because we're already 550 pips in profit. So my risk reward ratio is fine. And for a take profit on this, I haven't even thought about it yet. But now that you ask me, it'll probably be the top of the channel line. So if I can just zoom out a bit, I might take profit. You can't even see it on my screen. This top of the channel line, I might look somewhere around there for a profit target. Okay? Unless something fundamentally changes. If a DA wins the election suddenly or something like that, I might change my mind. But otherwise, I'll go for the long run. I'm not into sitting, staring at charts all day long. That's not for me. I used to do that a lot when I was younger. Now I analyze, I wait for the right opportunity, I buy, and I sit back, and while I'm sleeping, while I'm surfing, while I'm going out on dates with girls, I am making money, and you should be doing the same. You shouldn't waste all your time sitting, staring at 5-minute charts going up and down. Okay, so we're going to move on to the next one, though. On smaller time frames, though, okay, you're not going to use a 200 pip stop loss on a smaller time frame. If you are trading on a daily time frame, you could maybe put it 50 pips below. You know, most people are putting their stop loss 20 pips below the previous low or the trend line or the 61.8. So when they go hunting stops, they're going to knock it about 25 pips through and hunt all those stops, harvest all those stops. So make sure you're a bit below those guys. Don't be one of those, there's a name for it, I can't remember now, Nagging Nelly, or don't be one of those guys that put your stock with all the other guys. Okay, it's a beginner's mistake. Make sure you put it a little bit further away. How to calculate pips? Okay, there's a very easy way. Click your crosshair. It depends on whether you're on a 4 or 5 digit broker. Let's go to a normal currency pair quickly. GBP, USD. How many pips did I make on this trade? You zoom in a bit. How many pips did we make on this trade? Okay, we get the crosshair out. Now, as you can see here, I'm on a 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 digit broker. Most of you have an extra digit. You have a pipette. Okay? Now, if I draw from the top to the bottom with my crosshair, the first number is 43. That's how many candles there are. So there's 43 days from the beginning, from this point to this point. From when I entered the trade, and where we are now is about 43, 44 days. The next number is how many pips. I'm up 1,039 pips. Now, on most of your platforms, you're going to have an extra digit. Yours will say 10392 or 10395. That last digit you need to ignore. It's a pipette. Okay? I've got a special setup here. I've got one less digit. So that my stuff works a little bit easier. I prefer it this way. But on 99% of brokers, you're going to have a pipette. So this number that you see now of 1042, your number will have an extra digit, which you just need to completely ignore. The other way, of course, is drawing a line there where you're selling and there where you are now and looking at this number and deleting. Subtracting this number from this number, and it'll give you the amount of pips. That's the long way. I prefer to just use my crosshair, obviously. It's so much easier. Let's see, any more questions? What made me go short on this one? Okay, well, let's have a look, guys. Who can guess? Who can tell me? It looks like I was top picking, doesn't it? You know what they say about top pickers and bottom pickers? In the end, they all become cotton pickers. When I put this trade on SA Traders Lounge, people were telling me I'm crazy. They're saying, you're going against the trend. You don't know what you're doing. Blah, blah, blah. That's when I just started SA Traders Lounge and people didn't know who I was in South Africa yet. And when you look at this view, it sure as hell does look like I was top picking, wasn't I? This is clearly an uptrend. And I just went and sold there, hoping that this is where the trend changes. But that's not what I did. You guys have to remember, I'm a professional. I don't even really trade the dailies. Look at this monthly chart. Okay, we've got a supply. I'm not going to get into too much detail about the supply area that we have because that is not basics. And we're sticking with basics tonight. But as you can see, here's a previous high that the market made right here with the crosshairs. So let's draw a line there. Okay, can you guys see how people obviously went short on this line, expecting double tops? Okay, some of them might have even gone short over here, placing their stop losses just above this line over here. Okay, so most of the stops were probably placed around here, just above. Now you see what the big boys did. They just went and stopped all those people out. Now, they dragged in all the people that are saying, wow, it's a breakout trade. We're going higher. Right? So now everyone's been stopped out short, and they start buying to go long. And what happens? The market comes straight back in, and all those longs get stopped out. Me, of course, I got in right at the false break. This is also called a bull trap. I'm not going into it now because it's advanced. You guys will get advanced session from me, my next session. Sandile will be doing the beginner stuff because I don't like doing beginner stuff anymore. But yeah, as you can see, the reason for going short comes off the monthly chart. This is a clear turnaround position. There's your A, there's your B, and sorry, there's your A, there's your B, and there's your C. So we're at this supply zone, and if we draw our FIBs, from the last eye there down to the bottom, you'll see we are also in the fib zone. See that? The area between the 50 and the 61.8. I coined it the fib zone because that's the only area I look at fibs. I might as well delete all these other lines. And then if we look at stochastics at the same time, at the time of the trade, stochastics was turning down from an overbought position. So once again, very simple trade, nothing too complex there. There's a sound breaking up a bit there by you. It's probably bad connection in Cape Town. I don't know if you're using proper internet like we are here, or if you're using one of those modems. I'm very sorry. Unfortunately, there's nothing I can do about that. If you watch the video on YouTube afterwards, the sound should be perfect. So if you miss anything now, you can always go get it then. Give me a sec to read some of these questions quick, guys. Okay, Adam. Adam wants to know. Okay, Adam, you're asking me about false breaks. Yes, I did wait for the first down bar, but I'm not going to get into it now, Adam. Let's talk about this at my next session because there's a lot of beginners here. So I don't want to be talking about bull traps and false breaks. I rather want to help the beginners tonight. My next one, I will go so advanced, your head will spin, my man. What else have we got here? I make it look too easy. Yeah, that's what 15 years of experience does, guys. But yeah, seriously, bonds, it is easy. That's the thing. It is that easy. It's all these indicators and crap systems that are making 95% of traders lose money. If you stick to the basics and you do it correctly, you'll make money. Like someone will say, but I'm using Fibonacci. You're not using it correctly. You're selling when the price gets to the 23.6 level or the 38.2 level. It hardly ever turns around there, only in a very strong trend. Okay? The high probability area is the FIB zone, the area between the 50 and the 61.8. Now try and find that on the internet. No, the internet tells you use this level, use that level. You can't. You need someone that knows what they're doing to teach you, and then it is easy. The YouTube link, well, my man, I've only just decided to record this. The YouTube link, you're going to have to wait a while for. Like I said before, I'm a full-time trader. I do this as charity work. I do this to help people. So you guys can't expect me to spend the whole day tomorrow sorting out a YouTube link. You got to just wait until it's up there. And when it's up there, I'll post it on SA Traders Lounge. Okay? I'm a full-time trader, so I need to spend my time trading as well. Let's see what other questions you have. If you have a small account, would you advise trading longer time frames? Absolutely. You can trade 0.01. You can even get with InstaForex, you can even get a 1 cent account where every pip is 1 cent. Okay? I always advise trading long time frames. And even if you've got like a $50 account, you can get, that's the smallest account I know of, you can get with INFX off our website. There's a link. If you're trading 0.01, you can still trade the weeklies and the dailies. You just won't be able to do too many trades at the same time. More questions. Let's see here. How do you determine when to close the short? Okay, there's a few ways. I'm going to go into the first way where we look at possible resistance. If we draw our fibs from the bottom upwards. See where it's hitting the 50 now? It's starting to bounce a bit. You see that? It's finding resistance on, once again, the FIB zone. I'm expecting us to come lower down to this level, to this demand level over here, but you're definitely going to find resistance in the FIB zone, and we might even turn back up in the FIB zone. All the turning happens in the FIB zone. I'm not going to spend too much time on profit targets right now. Stop losses are much more important for beginners. We'll chat on Facebook. Yeah, absolutely, guys. SA Traders Lounge. Forget that Durban Traders Corner. It's just a bunch of ads on there. And the guys that are there giving you advice, ask them for their results. Not one of them will give you proper live results. They'll give you a screenshot of one day's trading or something crappy like that. They're all faking their results. There's only three ways that you can give someone results. One way is like this, using FX Blue or My FX Book or mt4i.com, which is the same as FX Blue. They log into your account and show your account results to people live. It cannot be fake. Okay? That's the two ways you can do that. The other way is getting broker verified results. If I just go back to our website, even on the homepage, I've got it. This little graph that comes up here, you can see at the bottom, verified by instaforex.com. So this is a widget. This is hosted on the InstaForex website, and it updates automatically to my website. So I can't type these numbers in myself or anything. And you can log into their website and look at all these details. Okay, those are the only three ways, or two ways. One is using a site like FXBlue, mt4i.com, or myfxbook.com. The other way is using broker verified results like this. And then, of course, logging into your account in front of someone is the last way. But don't fall for these screenshots of look how much I've made last night. And conveniently, the bit where it says demo account has been cut off on the top. Also, results of less than a year is good for a student, but it's not good for a professional. Okay, professionals need 4 or 5 years of results to mean anything. If you've got 1 year's results, I'll respect you and I'll chat to you as a professional. If you don't have 1 year's of results, you're still learning. You're not a pro yet. You're not there yet. How can you get more lessons in Zimbabwe? We are expanding to the rest of Africa soon, but you got to be patient through the South America, and I like them chicas. So we're going to be going to South America before we go to Zimbabwe, I'm afraid. Okay, that's enough for the questions. Right, let's get back to the charts. Okay, so profit on this one is currently, as we said, it's over 1,000 pips. Nice little trade. And we go back to the daily chart. There, people that thought I was top picking, they just weren't looking at the bigger picture. They were looking at hourly charts, 4-hourly charts, weekly, daily charts, but they were not looking at the monthly charts. This is looks like an uptrend on the daily, sure, but on the monthlies, it's all the way down from here. Look at that. That's a downtrend, okay? If you're using moving averages, which I don't, but if you're using a 200-day moving average, it'll probably show you that the trend is down. I don't need to use moving averages because I can just see. We were up there, now we're down here. It's a downtrend. It doesn't take a rocket science or any moving averages to figure that out. Okay, now let's see. Let's move on to the next one because we're running out of time, guys. And I've got a bribe that I've got to get to. Like I said, I do this out of the goodness of my heart. You're not paying me for this. So don't expect me to be here all night. I'm joking. Well, we started a bit late, so we'll carry on a bit late. Euro Canadian, another one very similar to the previous one. What happened here? Who can tell me why I sold here? Talk about it quick. I only use two indicators and I don't use them the way that anybody or that you guys do. Indicators lag, they tell you what has already happened. And we can see what's already happened. We want to know what is going to happen. Okay? So please forget about moving averages and all that crap. Okay? I use stochastics. Stochastics has a 20 line down here and it's got an 80 line up there. When stochastics is over the 80 line and it starts turning back down below, it comes back from overbought. That's a sell signal. And the same at the bottom. If it comes below the 20 line and it starts turning up, that's a buy signal. Okay, obviously we don't trade on just one signal. We're using high probability trading. So I want to see more things in place than just a stochastics overbought. But that's the one indicator that I use. The other one I use is MACD divergence. I'm not going into it now, but I will tell you briefly that you need to do it on the histogram. Forget using divergence with a two-line MACD. And for God's sakes, please, I see some sites like Baby Pips saying you can use divergence on stochastics. Guys, they don't know what they're talking about. You cannot use it. It's so inconsistent. You won't even get 50% results, okay? Use the histogram on MACD. We can chat about that in the advanced webinar that I'll do next. I don't know exactly which day next week. Just keep an eye out on SA Traders Lounge. We'll go into MACD divergence. If you do it correctly, it's got an over 90% success rate. So it's a brilliant technique. Let me look at some questions quick. Am I not scared of news events and some holding trades for long period? If you're trading the bigger time frames, you don't have to worry about short-term news events. Obviously, long-term policy shifts I do look at, but things like the dollar being in crap because they've got so much debt, they're paying billions every day just in interest. So I know more or less that the dollar is going to keep getting weaker. They're going to keep printing money. In the short term, they might say, ooh, we're going to hike interest rates. And there'll be a little bit of a bounce. But they're talking nonsense because they can't afford to do it, because then they won't be able to pay the debt. So I do keep a long-term view. But once again, it's outside the scope of this webinar. It's for newbies. So let's keep the fundamentals aside. I've been studying them for 15 years, and I'm still not an expert, in my opinion. Fundamentals are a lot harder than most people think. So the two indicators I use is I use stochastics to see overbought and oversold, and I use the MACD histogram to see divergence. Someone wants to know where to download the webinar. Guys, I don't know yet. Keep an eye on FX Trader Lounge. I'll put a link up there as soon as I've done it. Okay, can anyone tell me why I shorted right at the top? Did I have a crystal ball that told me the trend is up, 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 up? Hey, let's short it over here. This looks like a good place. How did I know to sell here? Anybody? I'm not getting any answers here. I'll give you guys a hint. Look at the bigger time frames. Look at the bigger picture. Fib zone, yeah, absolutely, but not on this time zone. Trend break, no, weekly time frame. Guys, let me just give you the answer. This is how simple trading is. I hope you're all paying attention right now. Okay, I hope every single one of you is paying attention. This is how simple trading is. We're on the monthly chart of the Euro Canadian. It looks like we're moving down, so we've got a point A over here, a point B down here, and we're looking for a point C somewhere over here where we can sell, right? Because we've been moving down. So we get our Fib tool. Because the impulse wave is down, the move is down, we start from the top and we draw our Fibs from the top to the bottom. We try and get it nice and accurately. There we go. Right on the 61.8, so in the Fib zone, is where I did the sell. What's this candle called that we've got here? Let me zoom in a bit. What's this candle called? Who can tell me? It's a big lag here, so I can't really get your answers. I'm still getting answers. There's a doji here, okay. Doji, it is technically not a doji because it has a little bit of body, but I don't care what you call it. It's a candle that's got a lot of wick sticking to the upside. So it's telling me that we're going to turn down. I'd say that's a shooting star. You can call it a doji. You can even call it an upside down hammer if you want to. I really don't care. Shooting star is the correct word. Yes. Morning star also. The main thing is there's a big wick pointing upwards. So this shows me there's a fight going on. Wherever you see big wicks, it's showing you that there's fighting going on. All the way up here, the bulls were in control. Yeah, the bears weren't really doing anything. It was bulls, 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 all the way up. Now, before I go against that strong bull move, I want to see that the bears are putting up a fight. Now, if you go to Afghanistan or some war zone, how do you know that there's a war going on? You can see signs. You see bullet holes in the walls. You see burnt out cars. You see, you know, there's signs. Now, in Forex, when there's a war going on between bulls and bears, there's also signs. Okay? And those signs are long candle wicks. That's a sign that there's a fight going on. So even though the bulls were under tested all the way up to here, the bears said, this is the flip zone. This is where we want to turn down. This is where we're going to start fighting. And the fact that the wick points to the upside shows that the bears were more powerful, because the price came all the way to the top, but the bears pushed it all the way down. So this shows us that there's a fight because there's big wicks, and it even shows us that the bears are stronger because the big wick is pointing to the top. So the reason for selling, we're in the fib zone. Look at stochastics. It's overbought. What more do you need? You got candle info, stochastics overbought, in the fib zone, on a monthly chart. And let's see how many. I'm just going to go down to the weekly chart so we can do a more accurate measurement. How many pips we took here? 1,500 pips, roughly. We're up. Yeah, so from there down to there, it's about 1,500 pips, right? And did I have to do anything for that? Yeah, I did something once. I analyzed, I waited for the opportunity, and I pulled the trigger. I haven't even really looked at this trade since then. Every now and again, someone says, hey, post it on SA Traders Lounge because we're in so much profit, show everyone. And then I'll go, look, okay, and I'll post it. I don't need to look. My analysis is solid. I know where this is going. Okay, and that's the beauty of the long. Where's my stop loss? My stop loss would have been way up here somewhere, but I haven't even got it in yet because it would take months to get there. Okay, if price did break the high of this candle over here, if price broke the high of that hammer, I would start thinking about where I would place my stop. It's a very bad habit to do that for beginners. You guys should always go in with your stop exactly where you want it. But for me, I've been doing this a little while longer. I've got a general idea of where my stop is, and I use that to calculate my risk to decide my position size. For you, you always need to put in a hard stop. Always. It's essential. Do as I say, not as I do. Did I wait for the shooting star to close? No, I actually entered on the 61.8. I could see it was coming down and turning into a shooting star. A lot of people will tell you, you have to wait for the candle to close. I was confident enough in my analysis to take the trade before the shooting star even closed. Okay, also because I took it right on the 61.8. And as you can see, this poke through the 61.8, it's just again the brokers and the big boys taking out all the stop losses. All the people that went short in the fib zone put their stop loss, let me draw a line. They put their stop losses here on that line. That's where all their stops were. So what happened? All their stops got harvested. And then the price went in the direction that they knew it was going to go into. It's a terrible feeling when that happens, isn't it? You knew the price was going to go down. And just as you get stopped out, the price turns around and goes down. Yeah, it happens all the time. There's a reason for it, guys. It's not coincidence. You're putting your stops where everyone else is putting their stops. It's easy to harvest them. Where do I place my profit? Hey, I haven't even thought about that yet. This trade can run till next year probably. So maybe next year sometime I'll have a think about that. Obviously, first point of resistance would be this level because there's previous highs here. Another thing I would do is draw Fibonacci and say, okay, when we get into this area, the zone will get some resistance as well. I'm not really bothered. I've already taken plenty of profit on the way down. The lot that I've got in now is going to stay for the bottom. So I'm not taking any more profit on this until we get somewhere down here. Okay, so was this trade difficult, guys? Can anyone tell me, was there anything magical to this trade? Was there any magical indicators used? Was there anything here that's too difficult for anyone to understand? No, of course not. Of course not. People that want you to think trading is complicated and you need to know all these systems, and when this crosses that and this crosses that. Forget all that stuff, guys. Smoke and mirrors, I promise you. Anyone that trades like that, just ask them for their results. I can't believe in this business how many people will believe that you're a professional trader just because you say you are. I know guys taking taxis to their office and saying that they're professional traders. They're living with their mums and saying that they are professional traders. I shit you not, pardon my friends. Guys, results, that's all. Ask results. If anyone has an opinion about trading, say to him, okay, show me your results, and then I'll decide whether to consider your opinion or not. Because everybody thinks they're an expert in this game. Okay, if there's no more questions on this one, everyone's happy. It's easy, it's basic, it's simple. There's nothing fancy to it. You can all do it. I'm going to do one more chart because we're out of time. Let's see. Australian dollar, US dollar. I know loads of you followed this trade as well. It was actually brought to my attention to someone by one of the group members, Banner, in SA Traders Lounge, went, hey, check out Australian dollar. And I was like, woohoo. I didn't see that one. I was busy doing some other stuff. I didn't see that trade. That's a lovely trade. And we took the trade together. He decided to put in a tight stop. I told him, don't put in a tight stop. It's a newbie mistake. Sorry, Vanner, for putting it out like this, but unfortunately, Vanner got stopped out. And when Vanner looks at this chart, he's probably kicking himself right now because he called this trade. He called it correctly. I'll show you guys what it's based on in a sec. But he called this trade correctly, and it was a beautiful trade, and we've made, let's see how much profit we've made off it. That is 350 pips so far. Okay, now just to try and cut it short, how do I choose my currency pairs? I see here. Guys, I stick with the majors mostly, because they got smaller spreads, but because I'm trading the bigger time frames, it doesn't matter that much, because whether you pay 1 pip spread or 10 pip spread, if you're taking 1,000 pips as your profit target, it doesn't really matter that much, you know? So I sometimes trade some of the exotics. For beginners, I definitely advise you to stick with the majors. There's more news for them. They're more stable. Like the South African government might nationalize the mines tomorrow. The British government is not going to do something crazy like that overnight. So it's more predictable, if you know what I mean. So stick with the majors, stay away from the exotics. There are so many currency pairs to choose from. Just by trading the major pairs with a small spread, you'll always find trades. Okay, so once again, it looks like perfect top picking. We picked this right at the top, right? We sold right here. How beautiful. No, guys, that's not what it is at all. It's not what it is at all. I didn't just pick this top by accident. The market was moving up, up, up. I didn't just know this is the best place to sell. How did I know? Let's see if we look at the monthly chart. Okay, sorry, guys. This is now, again, you're not really ready for this. It's supply and demand. We'll discuss this in the next webinar. Okay, the FIB, you guys know already on the monthly chart. If we look at the FIB, you can see that the FIB just turned down from an oversold position. And you can also see this candle. See, what's the candle called, guys? It's a hammer. Yeah, it's a hammer. On the dailies, you can also see a beautiful hammer over there. Very nice. And yeah, there's just a very nice zone over here. You can see the zone that the market has come up to once, twice, three times. It's even broken out. Let's show me again where the brokers stop people out. Get this. Well, actually, we can just use my sell line as a reference point. You can see that the market bounced off here. The next time it got there, people sold. They thought, ooh, double tops, let's sell. And what did the brokers do? I say brokers, it's actually the big boys, guys. It's not the brokers. What did they do? They went and stopped you out. All the short traders got stopped out because they didn't want to pay out all of this. So they stopped you out. All the newbies thought, what's the first strategy every newbie learns on the internet? break out trading. It's the worst strategy there is. You'll just lose your money. But okay, we've got a breakout now because we've broken this previous high. So they all buy. What happens then? Market comes straight back down and stops all of them out. Market goes down and you say, damn, I was short in the first place. I knew it was going to go down. Now I got stopped out. Then I went long. I got stopped out again. And now it's going short, just like I originally thought. And oh, my account's blown. Guys, I've seen this happen a million times. A million times. If you just give your stop loss enough room to maneuver, a lot more of your trades will work out. Okay, I met a guy who works for, I'm not going to mention the name of the company because I worked with him before as well. He came to do a course for the third time with us. He wasn't making money. This guy knew everything about trading. I asked him, what about this? What about, he knew everything. He was a dedicated student. Okay, his name's Christian. Very dedicated student. Yet he just wasn't making money. And it's not like he didn't know what he was doing. I took one look at his trade history and I could immediately see tight stop losses. He wanted to go in with bigger lot sizes, so he used tighter stops and it was biting him in the ass time and time again. His analysis was perfect. He's a brilliant trader. He was just going in with tight stops. And the minute he started using bigger stops, you, those of you who know who Christian is and who he works for, ask him how his trading has improved since he started giving the market room to improve, room to move. Makes a huge difference, and that's a number one newbie mistake. Okay, that's it for the webinar. I'm going to answer some more questions, so go ahead and ask your questions. I'll give you guys another 5 or 10 minutes of answering questions before I go and have a nice fillet steak on the braai. You can enter a trade on a monthly time, anytime, or just at the start of that month. No, not just at the start of the month, guys, but don't chase price. Chasing price is a very bad habit. For example, I had a question on SA Traders Lounge when I posted this trade. They said to me, okay, it's now a good time to go short. Now, guys, come on, man. A good time to go short was up here where we went short. Okay, this is maybe a good time to go long. I'm not saying it is, but it sure as hell isn't a good time to go short. It's like anything in life. If you want to buy a car, okay, you want to buy a surfboard. You want to buy a surfboard. When it's winter time, people don't really surf, so they sell their surfboards for cheap, right? When it's summer, everyone wants to buy a surfboard, so there's a lot of demand. So when is the best time to buy a surfboard? In winter when it's cheap, or in summer when everyone wants a surfboard and they're expensive? When's the best time to buy a second-hand surfboard? It's going to be in winter time because you're going to get it cheaper. Yeah, and when's the best time to sell your surfboard if you want to sell your second-hand surfboard? Sell it in summer when everyone's looking for a surfboard. Yeah, it's the same with anything in life. Trading is no exception. You want to sell when the price is high. I sold my surfboard in the middle of summer up here. And you want to buy when the price is low. It's the example of a buyer. No, they're all actually sells. You want to buy when the price is low. The lower the price, the better it is to buy. The higher the price, the better it is to sell. It's simple, guys. There's nothing. Yeah, in wintertime, you're right, Mduzi. There's nothing different in trading than anything else in real life. Supply and demand decide the prices, and you want to buy it cheap and sell it for expensive. That's how the market vendors, the guys pushing their trolleys in the road, selling Kit Kats and whatever else they have in those trolleys. That's how they make their money. They buy the Kit Kat for R1 and they sell it for R1.50. He's made money. He's bought it cheap and he sold it for more expensive. That's what you want to do in Forex. So if the price has gone down to a very low level, that's not a good place to sell. If the price has gone very high, it's not a good place to buy. Your moving averages will tell you, ooh, the price has gone up, your moving averages will cross up, and it'll give you a buy signal. But the price is already high. It's too late to buy. You should have bought when it was cheap. Okay, guys, I hope you get that. And I hope I didn't talk too far over you guys in the session. Like I said, I'm not really used to dealing with beginners. Sandile will be helping you beginners out once a week with a webinar. I'll be doing the advanced once a week as well. We're doing twice a week in-person mentoring as well. You guys can book your free seats on the globalforexinstitute.co.za website. Okay, or you can go to our Facebook page. There's probably links there as well where you can book it. You can even phone us. Our office number, if you need anything, our office number is 031-583-7305. You'll be phoning internationally. Yeah, the code is 0027. Internationally, it would be, let me just type it here. Internationally, it would be 0027315837305. That's if you're phoning internationally. Okay, during South African office hours only. And guys, please stop bugging me on my mobile late at night. I know I give my mobile number out very easily, but when you guys ask me at 12 o'clock at night about a trade while I'm busy with a girlfriend, I'm not impressed. Okay, so don't do it. Only joking. I don't give my number out that easily. Okay, guys, I hope you enjoyed the session. I will be back here next week, same time, same place, but only for advanced students. Those are probably the ones that have already done courses with Global Forex Institute. For the beginners, keep an eye. Sandile is a great teacher. Keep an eye on FX Trading Lounge, and SA Trading Lounge, and you will get information on there about that course. I'm starting to go a little bit crazy. It's weird talking to myself, so I'm going to cut off if there's no more questions. I hope you guys enjoyed it. Yeah, thank you very much. Thanks, guys. You're a great crowd. I just wish I could talk to you, but it's not possible. If everyone talks over each other, it's a big mess. I tried it once before. I'll get a different system for next week, maybe Skype or something. I'll figure out something, because I looked into licenses. Even with a license, this software only takes 25 users, and we've got about 2,500 users that want to come into this chat. So I'll have to find another way, but I will. Don't worry. Thanks a lot for coming, guys. Have a good evening wherever you are, or morning if you're in Japan. Chat to you all on SA Traders Lounge. George van der Riet, I'm out.